You know, sometimes I think Christians give this image that you have to be good to get to heaven. Can I tell you, the Bible's very clear. You aren't good enough. I'm not good enough. There's not enough goodness in all of us collectively to make any one of us capable of going to heaven. We don't go to heaven because we're good. We go to heaven because God is good. And because He's offered us eternal life through faith in His Son, Jesus Christ. Now, I will tell you this. Once you've been saved, you have a responsibility to live a good life in appreciation for what God has done for you. But you can't earn your salvation by being good enough. You can't maintain it by being good enough. If you depend on your ability, you're never going to get there. It's all based in the grace of God. So nobody's here today saying, wow, you know, we're really good and you're really not. We're all people who have one of two things. Either we have received God's grace or we need to receive God's grace. It's not a matter of us being good enough. This place that you wind up happens because you reject Christ. You do not receive what He's done for you. And if you stay on the broad path, that is where that path leads to. Anybody ever been lost? Anybody ever been lost when you didn't know you were lost? Anybody ever drive down the road and all of a sudden you realize, I'm in the wrong place. How did I get here? You know, I remember one time when I was in Missouri doing the camps and district youth director, and I was driving back from the camp and there's a road you turned off of. Coming back, our house was 2.5 hours from the camp, and I was driving home from camp, and I was talking to Janet on my cell phone, and I said, you know, I'm coming home, I'll be there in a few minutes. And all of a sudden, you probably don't know central Missouri, but there's a town called Osage Beach, which is really funny in the middle of Missouri, called Osage Beach, but anyway, there's that, and there's a town called Eldon, and they're kind of near each other. And if you don't turn off to go to Osage Beach, you wind up in Eldon. And I'm talking to her, and I said, well, I left the camp, you know, about 25 minutes ago, and, you know, I'm almost to Osage Beach, and, you know, I'll be there. And I look up, and I'm pulling into Eldon. And I was talking to her on the phone. I missed my turn. I said, I'm going to be about 30 minutes later than I thought I was going to be because I missed my turn. You know, now here's the bad part about it. You can be on the wrong path and not even realize you're on the wrong path if you don't look around and see the road signs. But the Bible says if you're on this path, understand, I didn't want to go to Eldon. Eldon was out of the way. I didn't think I was going to Eldon, but I wound up in Eldon. No one, or very few people, would ever say, you know what, I'm going to eternity without God. I'm going to spend eternity in hell. But the reality is this, if you don't get off the broad path and get on the narrow path, that is the destination that you're headed toward. Now, here's the good news. There's a narrow path, the path of constriction, the path where you have to lay down your opinions, your rights, your ideas, and you have to become a follower of Christ. But here's the good news about that. That leads to a place called heaven. I love heaven because the Bible tells in Revelation 21 that in heaven there are no more tears. There's no more pain, there's no more sorrow, there's no more death. In our Sunday school class this morning, we looked at the story of Lazarus being raised up from the dead and how that when Jesus saw it, he wept. And I think that he probably wept because he was angry about the destruction that sin and death had brought into the world and the pain that was caused by it. Wouldn't it be a great day when there's no more tears, there's no more pain, there's no more sorrow, there's no more death, there's no more sin, there's no more night, there's no more curse? We're with God and Jesus forever in a glorious city that goes beyond description. Paul says in 1 Corinthians 2:9, he said, there's not enough words to describe, and our brain is not big enough to comprehend how incredible the things that God has planned for us.